think Daisy really even had a choice.
What do you mean?
Right about now, I'm planning a pair of scissors in her back to protect a child she was never going to harm. She chose to die for her revolution. What about me? For all the endless worlds, all the infinite possibilities, did I ever even have a choice? Did you?
Yeah. Booker thought he did.
Look where it got us. Right back where we started.
Okay, here's the thing about, in my opinion, here's the thing about infinite timelines and infinite possibilities. Kind of like the whole thing with the constants and variables, it's the idea that everything has to kind of be seen in some variety. So I think in some timelines, as limited as it could possibly be, I think there are some in which Booker is still Booker and Elizabeth is still his daughter and like none of this shit happened. We're just seeing one of the thousand possibilities that there could be. But if that's true or not, I really don't have any, you know, evidence to kind of support that basis. But I would kind of like to think that for everything to be okay, or for, you know, I guess the universe not to implode in on itself, every possibility has to be foreseen. It has to be seen in some variety or whatever. So, like, maybe Rosalind never actually made contact with Robert, and so, like, they never became a brother and sister pairing. Like, and they maybe, like, one, they never really did die. Maybe that's a possibility. Or if they did die, it's, like, when they did pass on this timeline, or the other timelines as well, where they passed, or where they were killed. What if when that happened, even if, like, they weren't supposed to die in those timelines, they did, and they all just I don't know, it's weird. This is so weird. It's a weird thing to think about. Because they're making it sound like Elizabeth and Booker and Comstock and everyone involved in this game, if you will, never really got a chance to make choices to say, yeah, I'm going to do that, or yeah, I'm not going to. But there's always the possibility that Booker said to Comstock, because Comstock, the reason why Comstock was able to take Elizabeth is because, basically speaking, Robert or Rosalind or whoever, I think it was Robert, went to Booker. In the timeline where he had Elizabeth, and Robert to Booker saying, my boss, which is basically Comstock, will pay for all of your expenses as far as your debt and everything. All you have to do is bring us the girl. That's all you need to do. And that's why Booker hands Anna, Elizabeth, over to Robert, because Booker decides to take Comstock up on his offer and switches, you know, gets money for Elizabeth. Obviously, he tries to change his mind near the end of that, and that went very badly. But there could be a possibility in which he never gives Elizabeth away. That maybe he strains himself out or something. I don't know. It just, there's always a possibility. There always is.
All these infinite universes.
Oop.
And yet we end up just going down the same paths.
No, I'll take your meaning.
My father sold me to settle a marker. Comstock locked me up in a tower. And I sold Sally for what? Revenge? To prove a point?
And yet, here you are. Settling the debt.
And say we find her. The old past there damaged to the young. Isn't it too late for her now?
Well, I'd say that's up to her to decide. Justice coming back here was up to you.
Rapture runs on children. Little girls with gold growing in their bellies. I'm not gonna break any cycle. If I'm lucky, maybe I can dent it. Just a little.
But that's what it comes down to, choices. Because there could possibly be a timeline or an alternate reality in which Elizabeth does not go back for Sally. That she's like, fuck it, I've already done my part, I made peace. But we were playing Elizabeth, who obviously was not happy with that choice and went back to Rapture to fix this problem. But there always has to be a possibility in which she never made that choice. Because you always have choices. So once you make a decision, there could be a completely different version of you that could be exactly the same as you up until that exact point where you made one decision and the other version of you made the complete opposite. Like, there's always choices. So there has to be a way in which everyone's fine. As weird as that sounds, there has to be. I mean, if fan fiction has taught me everything, there has to be. Are you shitting me? Ah! See anyone, but I'm so scared right now. I just find it interesting that it would give us a hairpick lock. Like, I didn't lose a lockpick on that one. Pretty sure I did. That's the wrong button. Yeah, no, I still have 12, so I'm fine. I didn't lose anything on that. Oh, I can't get gas? Ah, son of a gun. I have yet to use that gas tranquilizer dart properly. I kind of want to redeem myself. I'm not really quite sure how. I don't know. Maybe I should shoot properly and do it properly. Oh, that might be it. That's a smart idea. There are people outside. I don't see anything. Oh god, I forgot that we had that fight. Yeah, because there's the handyman. Holy shit. Hi, buddy. Yeah. Yep, there's no one else here. And there's Fink! He died! Unshot to the head. There's so many dead bodies around, oh my god. Judging by the amount of death that plagues this area, I'd say that Booker was in the area. Just a thought. Wait a minute. Hold on, time out. Wait. If our Booker and Elizabeth made it to the First Lady, technically speaking, it's not supposed to be there anymore because they left with it. So, technically speaking, that should be gone. What the hell? Oh, look, Eve, that I don't need. Oh, look. Hi, Daisy. Anyway. Oh, I can't go in here now. Yep, there's Fink. Him in his top hat and his striped tie of something. Oh, it's gone, but the terror remains.
Pretty lady has the hair?
Yes.
Deal is deal. Bring it to Soo-chung.
Okay. I mean, I don't know what else I want to do, but okay.
Pretty lady put hair sample in tube. Then, business is finished.
What's going on out there?
Bloodshed, violence, but not relevant to our arrangement.
Fair enough, I suppose. That's dark!
Soo-chung. Wow. Soo-chung, we had a deal, now open!
Ha! Huh. Oh, fuck.
You know what they call someone who enters a man's home uninvited. A thief. And I do not remember inviting you into my city.
I had a deal with Soo-chung.
Yi Soo-chung is my employee. It was not a deal he was authorized to make.
What do you want?
I granted Atlas and his thugs asylum. You serve those same men in a desire to escape from my generosity. If they shall not have asylum, then they shall have liquidation. Give a parasite an ounce of charity. He'll demand a pound.
I'm just looking for a girl that was taken from me. A little sister.
I don't claim to understand what you are. But I know that you are special. There is business we can do together. And so I give you a choice. Work for me, or die with Atlas.
I'm not going anywhere without that girl.
If it's a little sister you want, that shouldn't stand in the way of commerce. I've got dozens of them.
I won't leave without her.
My men stand ready to take down the door. In 60 seconds, they will enter the room.
Fuck!
They will either treat you as a valued employee of Ryan Industries.
Fuck!
Or as a thief in the night.
Fuck! Help! No!
60 seconds.
There should be half a dozen of them or more. I've got to get ready.
How?
No traps. I can use the plasmids as traps in it and seed the room with them. I gotta find someone.
Okay.
Surprise them. Take them down one by one. Booker, I'm scared.
They'll underestimate you, Elizabeth. People always do.
40 seconds.
Fuck!
What I see on your face?
What?
Uncertainty.
It's a good guess. Wait.
30 seconds.
No, shut up!
Do you know the value of the shark? Without them, she would be littered with detritus.
Ah, fuck.
Men who come for you have much in common with those great animals.
Fuck!
What sharks do for the ocean, these men do for rapture.
I don't
20
have...
20 seconds. I will tell you something you already sense. Atlas does not honor agreements. And Orion does.
Help?
I cannot save your Sally, but I can save you.
Shit.
Time. You're not a hero. You're not even a parasite. You're just a room. And Andrew Ryan has no time for rooms.
Oh. Not Houdini's. Fuck.
You should have taken Ryan's deal.
Shit.
I know you've done it.
Oh god. Shit! Fuck!
Let's make this easy on both of us.
Not in the mood for this hide and seek.
Oh, shit.
Hide it. That's out. I know you've done it.
Oh, fuck. How many are there?
Jerk. Should have never stuck. Snuck out.
Gotta do far away now. God damn it.
We're not all easy targets, you get me? Get back here! What was that?
God damn it. Shit!
Come on. You got my full attention.
That's just slightly unfair. Oh boy.
I beat your sharks, Ryan.
Huh?
The better man won. Isn't that the only thing you respect? Now let me the hell out of here.
What?
Sounds like all hell's breaking loose out there. What's your plan?
I can't just place the particle on the ceiling. It would just tear right through it. Every building in Rapture was submerged into the ocean on a lunette ring, connected to the junction of its load-bearing supports.
That's fascinating and all, but if you haven't noticed, Ryan sent his goons to murder us. If you're gonna pull a rabbit out of a hat, now's the time to do it.
The structural junction is in Frank Fontaine's office. If I can get there, I can float the building.
It so happens I've taken that bastard's office for my own use. I'll make sure you've access to the private elevator. Now hurry.
Well, fuck me. This is like living hell. Holy shit. I'm going down? I'm going down. Okay. Okay, yeah, it's moving this way. Hope this is not a timer. And it really should tell me where I'm supposed to go right now.
Had any principles, not around. You wouldn't be skulking around.
Fuck. I missed. Shit.
Been expecting you.
Stupid jerk. Should have never stuck his neck out.
Oh, are you shitting me? I moved.
That's how it's gonna be. I know you've done it.
Come on out. Let's make this quick. Stupid.
Okay, I think that's all. Well, maybe not all. Close, I suppose. Oh wow, they're like right there. Glad I ran in here.
What's going on? You're still here, aren't you?
Okay.
one. Show yourself. Goddamn time you showed.
What the hell?
Not in the mood for this hide and seek. Now you're in the soup. This won't take long. Don't think you can hide. This one's down for the count. Not all easy targets, you get me? Get back here! Not in the mood for this hide and seek.
Okay. Well, thank God the Big Daddy's not here anymore. Good God. Fine. It's all... Well, maybe.
There's supposed to be a brunette. Anyone seen...
Fuck.
Look around!
Shit. I can see too. Further, buddy. Come on.
Ran off? Now just get off my nose.
Shit. Nope. He's not out far enough.
Party's over, huh? Oh, well.
Woo! There's a lot of people here. You have good sleep, sir. You earned it. There are so many people here. Oh, okay. See, I'm just gonna go that way. Shit. Walk out. Can't get to him either. Oh, sure, now you walk out.
Idea crossing here.
I'm glad his cry of pain and fear did not alert anyone to my presence. Seriously? Something over here? Oh, shoot. Oh, it's in there. Why did I not see that? Hang on. Ah, it's shotgun ammo, no wonder. It's like, whoa, I didn't see that. Okay. One, two. I got two left. If I can get a clean shot on the guy closest to me.
Get in. Disappear the girl and Atlas's crew. Back before happy hour.
There. Get back here!
Ah, fuck. Help me. I swear to God, they multiply. Okay. I'm still gonna take this nice and freaking slow. Cause I hear more! Just don't s- okay, they're- I'm guessing the next room- ah, there's an upgrade! Shit! I got two. Shit. We have health, ammo, dude, and there's an upgrade over there in that room somewhere. So my guess is I'm also going to have more people I have to take out. Yay! Because this isn't hard enough as is. I can't tell if he's actually in this room or not. But if he is, that'd be sweet. If he's kept- oh, there, fuck, there's more than one. Shit. You kept just walking to the left. Okay, no, oh, fuck you. God damn it, you knew it! You knew it! You knew it! You knew- oh, god damn it. Yay, Eve. I did not need Eve. Is he out in this room? Well, if I can get up, that would help. Yep, he is, okay. Okay, I see two. Okay, I can do this.
Get in.
I can do this. Okay, he's going back up there, so I should be fine. Except I now have glass to worry about. Oh, fuck. Nope, he's up there. Okay, that's fine. Don't step on glass, please. You just snore off your sleep, sir. It's all good.
At this follows. Shit. Living on borrowed time, if you ask me.
Not Houdini. God damn it.
Who are you? Gonna make short work of
Can't keep running forever.
Come out here.
Thank you. I'll beat. Stupid jerk. Should have never stuck his neck out.
You're doing some lovely dance moves there, sir. Okay. Whew. Good God. Okay. I'm supposed to go this way, but I'm gonna search around a bit. As dumb as that sounds. I wish I had more trank darts. That'd be sweet. No, I don't need Eve. Nope, that's all. Oh, wait, hang on. Oh, now there's just Eve. Okay, that's fine. Wait. There's an upgrade. I swear to God there's an upgrade. Like right underneath me? Yeah, it is. Shit. Well, let's see how much I can suck at this one. Aha! I didn't suck at all! Okay. Wait. Is there someone here? No, it's just the upgrade. I swear to God, I heard someone. Keeping cloak mod. Removes Eve cost for invisibility while standing still. Sweet! I forgot that if I'm if I stand still, I'm invisible. Probably because I'm just so used to running around going, ah! Can I have that? Thank you. Oh, there's another one.
I never thought anyone would be able to bring all these degenerate splice heads into line. I gotta hand it to Atlas. After Ryan locked us up in this pit, I thought that was it. Just a long, final dive into the abyss. But he's given us hope. Or what passes for it down in Rapture. When a person's got nothing, hope's about the kindest thing you can give her. Or the cruelest.
Pretty much. Oh, it's Peeping Tom. Okay, I was like, I saw the woman as a skeleton, so I was like, what? What plasmid is that? Okay, I gotta go up here. I'm actually good. Holy shit. Here we go. To the depths, or I guess to the... Yeah, to the depths of despair. Eh, it's fine.
Elizabeth, you know Atlas is going to...
I know. And I'm ready.
Are Am I?
Sure.
I sent myself here for a reason. Didn't I?
Who exactly are you speaking to, Miss Comstock? If I were less acquainted with the vicissitudes of genius, I suspect I would question your sanity. I know so little of you, but I imagine the more I learned, the more exceptional I would find you.
Creepy!
You know Atlas will betray you.
Yes.
What are you, my best friend?
You're one of a kind in this world. Or others. And now, your misguided sense of altruism sends you to your doom. It's like watching Isaac Newton die in a house fire. A vain attempt to save his cat.
To be fair, a cat would be able to make it out of a house fire, but not a child. Just saying. No. Okay. Open the doors. Yes, I see nothing wrong with this. Well, it looks familiar.
There, there, there. All the load-bearing columns come into this room and they meet there. I just need to place the particle in that junction, activate it, and the whole structure should rise.
Okay, I'm glad it's just that easy. Yeah, I'm gonna snoop first, because that's what I do, apparently. Nothing? Really? You're just gonna have me act
There's
okay?
No plan B. Might as well just get it over with.
Hey, Elizabeth, let me just... I'm gonna snoop first. It's fine. Okay, let's do this. I'm expecting the worst. I always have to, I suppose.
Here goes nothing.
Oh, jeez. Yeah? Yeah! Oh my god!
It's working! Atlas, you feel that? You have your prison break. Now bring me the girl!
Oh shit! Ow, my face. And oh, fuck. Hi! What's up?
Great.
Your mom ever teach you not to put your faith in strange foreign
Just
men?
Just give me the girl. She means nothing to you.
You've got that right. The girl means nothing. But you, love, you mean the world.
Ah! Oh, yay, chloroform! Who the fuck didn't see this coming? I certainly did. Look, I'm double-crossed. Who's surprised? It's Atlas. God damn it. Should have known Atlas wouldn't hold us under the bargain. Yes. Yes, we should have. And we did. We just were prepared.